Hey guys, I'm going to build a piston memory tape system from start to finish, so you can see every step of the process here. So I'm going to make this a 4-bit system, so 4 blocks wide. So I start by digging a 4-block trench and put 4 pistons, regular pistons, in there. And wire that up. Make it a 6x6 tape. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And another 4 pistons here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Work. So now I need to go 6 up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And let's see. 2, 4, 5, 6. I'm just using this dirt as a scaffolding, so I can 1, 2, 3, 4. And I need to add a repeater in here, I think, just because of the length. I want to make sure that it will reach. So now I just need the last row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this one will be... about there. Now that should line up with that one. Just push it down to there. And now I just need to do the rest of them. Okay, and test this one out. Excellent. Okay, so now we need to build the drive system for this thing. And do that by building a 4 pulse. I'm gonna put it here. So dig a 2x2 hole and put torches at the bottom. And then let's see. I need to go this way, so put pistons in the corners like that. This one into that. This one into rock in there. Let me slow this down. So you can see this one got wired up automatically, and you can see that it's the only thing you need to be careful of is which direction it's going. It goes in the direction that the pistons are oriented, so when you put the pistons on this side, it goes counterclockwise, and when you put the pistons on the other side, it goes clockwise. And so I just know that you need them to fire in the correct order. If you have them firing backwards, it won't work. Because each piston needs to free up a space for the one pushing into that space. So if you just follow this, that will work out. So let's see, we're almost done with the drive system, and let me fill in the rest of these. How many do I have here? I'm gonna put in a couple glass blocks. And then you just feed in your blocks. So now they're all the same, rotating in the same direction. You've got the memory unit now. Now you need to build something so that you can read what's going on there. And so what you need is a reading. I'm going to do it right about here. Build a little 2-block wide thing. And put a bunch of repeaters in there. And you power it. And that's it. This is the only thing you need on the inside. What it does is it's shooting power into those blocks. If it's a glass block, the power won't pass through the block. If it is wool or any other conductive block, it'll move through to the other side. So now we need something on the other side that can pick up that signal. So another series of blocks. And, way to get up there. So you can see the 2 blocks that had glass, there's no signal coming through, and the 2 wool blocks are getting signaled.